वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज वेक्टर एलजेब्रा, चैप्टर नंबर 10 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस हैव द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर। लेट अस सी व्हाट इज देयर इन द चैप्टर। इंट्रोडक्शन। इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ we come across many queries such as what is your height, how should a football player hit a ball to give a pass to another player of his team. Observe that a possible answer to the first query may be 1.6 meters, a quantity that involves only one value, which is called magnitude, which is a real number. Such quantities are called scalars. However, an answer to the second query is a quantity which is called force, which involves muscular strength, that is magnitude, and direction in which another player is positioned. Such quantities are called vectors. In mathematics, physics, and engineering, we frequently come across with both types of quantities, namely scalar quantities such as length, mass, time, distance, speed, area, volume, temperature, work, money, voltage, density, resistance, etc., and vector quantities like displacement, velocity, acceleration, force, weight, momentum, electric field, intensity, etc. So, in this chapter, we will study some of the basic concepts about vectors, various operations on vectors, and their algebraic and geometric properties. These two types of properties, when considered together, give a full realization to the concept of vectors and lead to their vital applicability in various areas as mentioned above. First of all, some basic concepts. Directed line. What is a directed line? Suppose we are given three lines. This is L1 line, this is line 2, L2, and this is L3 line, right? Now, suppose the direction is given. The direction of line L1 is upward, so this is called the directed line. L2 has the direction this way, downward. But in third line, direction is also given. One more thing is given. What is that? Starting point and end point is also given. Okay, suppose starting point is A and end point is B. So in these three lines, what we find? L1 is a directed line. Suppose similarly L2 is a directed line. Here, L3 is also directed as well as its magnitude is also given. Right? So, what we say? We write this line as AB. AB is equal to line 3. Line 3 is AB. And in short, we can write this line as in the form of naming a single letter, small letter of English alphabet. A. Suppose this is vector A. So what is vector? Vector mean a directed line as well as the magnitude is also given. So this way, this is called vector A. We can call this as vector A. Our next point is position vector. What is a position vector? we shall discuss about this now. This is our three-dimensional right-handed rectangular coordinate system, x, y, z axis. They are inclined to each other at 90 degree angle. So how they are making 90 degree angle? This is the roof of my quarter. This is one corner where we see that three lines, they are inclined to each other at. In this coordinate system of axes, suppose there is any point P and the coordinates of this point are x, y, z. Now what we do? We are going to join O and P. O and P, they are joined this way with the help of the scale. Now this OP, OP is the directed line segment, right? Its initial point is O and terminal point is P. So initial point is given as well as terminal point is also given. So this line is called directed line. Suppose the name of this line is L. So what is L? So in place of L, we take this as R, vector R. Arrow sign will be there. So throughout the chapter, we shall consider this line segment OP as vector R. So what is R? This is OP, directed vector. So position vector of OP, this means position vector of P minus position vector of A, right? So position vector of P, that means x coordinate is of point P is x minus x coordinate of point O is 0, x minus 0, I mean in the direction of x axis, I unit, plus y minus 0 in the direction of y axis, j unit distance is there, plus z minus 0 in the direction of z axis. So consider k unit distance is this. So what we say, xi plus yj plus zk. So this way what we see, vector r is equal to xi plus yj plus zk. Throughout the chapter, this is very, very important. The value of vector r is this. One more thing, we can also find the distance of OP. Two-point formula. What is that? X minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square plus z minus 0 whole square. So what is OP? OP is considered as vector R. The magnitude of R becomes x square plus y square plus z square. So this is second thing. Throughout the chapter, we have to consider this result. The first one, this is the position vector of R is equal to xi plus yj plus zk. Second is showing the magnitude of vector r, which is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Now let there are three points in the coordinate system. Suppose this is point A, this is point B, and this is any third point C. Now we join these points. This way we have joined the points. Suppose the directions are also given. OA direction, OB, OC. So in practice what we say, position vector of OA is considered as vector A. So this whole position vector OA is written in short as vector A. Similarly, vector B, OB, position vector of OB is written as vector B in small. OC is considered as equal to vector C. Now we shall discuss about direction cosines. Let us see what is the meaning of this direction cosines. Again, suppose we have three-dimensional right-handed rectangular coordinate system. So this is the three-dimensional right-handed rectangular system of coordinate axis. Again, in this system, suppose there is any point P, and the coordinates of point P are, again they are same, x comma y comma z, and O is the initial point origin having the coordinates 0 comma 0 comma 0. Here position vector of OP, which is written as vector R. In short, first of all we shall discuss about direction angles. Direction angles, suppose alpha, beta and gamma are the direction angles. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is OP is the position vector of point P with respect to origin O. So the angle made by this R with the positive direction of x-axis, that angle is alpha. Here suppose first of all we have this angle. This is the triangle. Now I am going to draw. So this way we have the right angled triangle OAP. At A, angle is 90 degree, and suppose alpha is the angle which OP direction vector, this vector R, OP vector R is making alpha angle with positive direction of x-axis. So this is called direction angle alpha. Okay, so as we have mentioned here that OAP is a right angled triangle, and this way OAP, this is a right angled triangle. Here angle O is alpha angle as we have written. If magnitude of vector OA is equal to x, then what we say, OA is x and OP, the magnitude of OP vector, suppose this is R, so OP is R. So what we say now, cos alpha is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Sorry, this is R vector, OP is R, base is X divide hypotenuse is R. So this way cos alpha, this is called direction cosine in the direction of X axis. Similarly, we have direction angles beta, gamma. here with the direction positive direction of y axis, OP is making an angle beta. Again, this becomes right angle triangle. This is 90 degree angle, and this angle is beta. Lastly, we have OC with the positive direction of z axis. The angle made is gamma. This angle is gamma, and this angle is 90 degree angle. So what we say, alpha is the angle which is made by vector r with the positive direction of x axis, beta is the direction angle made by vector r with the positive direction of y axis, gamma is the direction angle made by vector r with the positive direction of z axis. Here accordingly these are also right angled triangles. So what we can say, we can say here the value of cos beta will be equal to y upon r. Similarly, the value of cos gamma, that will be equal to z upon r. Now these are called direction cosines. Cos alpha comma cos beta comma cos gamma are called direction cosines. So this way, direction cosines in short are written as direction cosines equal to cos alpha cos beta cos gamma. In short, we write cos alpha equal to L, cos beta equal to M, and cos gamma equal to N. Therefore, what we say, the value of L is equal to x upon r, the value of M is equal to y upon r, and value of N is equal to z upon r. So from this, what we can say, the coordinates of point P, x comma y comma z, they becomes LR, MR, NR. Now what we see, LR, MR, NR, they are the direction numbers. They are also called direction ratios, and we may call them A, B, C. So A, B, C, they are the direction numbers, direction ratios, and L, M, N, they are called direction cosines. Throughout the chapter, L, M, N, they are called direction cosines, and A, B, C are called direction numbers or direction ratios. Now what is the difference between direction cosines and direction ratios? Direction cosines, we have written them as L, M, N. Now what is the condition for this? L square plus M square plus N square is always equal to 1. Whereas direction ratios, in short we write them D dot RS dot, they are written as A comma B comma C. Just we can say that direction cosines and direction ratios are proportional to each other. Okay, this condition is not hold here, it may hold, but not permanently. Now we shall discuss about types of vectors. The very first type is zero vector. What is a zero vector? A vector whose initial point and terminal point coincide. That is AA vector. बी बी वेक्टर इज कॉल्ड जीरो वेक्टर. सो इन शॉर्ट जीरो वेक्टर इज रिटन एज जीरो वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू जीरो आई प्लस जीरो जे प्लस जीरो के. सेकेंड वन इज यूनिट वेक्टर. व्हाट इज यूनिट वेक्टर? सपोज ए इज एनी वेक्टर. दिस इज कॉल्ड यूनिट वेक्टर इफ इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड इज वन. ओके, इफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू वन देन वेक्टर ए इज कॉल्ड यूनिट वेक्टर. नेक्स्ट इज को इनिशियल वेक्टर्स. टू और मोर वेक्टर्स आर कॉल्ड को इनिशियल वेक्टर्स इफ देयर इनिशियल पॉइंट इज सेम. ओके, व्हाट वी से इनिशियल पॉइंट इज सेम. इनिशियल पॉइंट इज सेम सो दे आर कॉल्ड को इनिशियल वेक्टर्स. नेक्स्ट वन इज को लीनियर वेक्टर्स. टू और मोर वेक्टर्स आर कॉल्ड को लीनियर वेक्टर्स इफ सपोज दिस इज वेक्टर ए एनी वेक्टर अनदर वेक्टर इज दिस एंड देयर इज वन मोर लाइन थर्ड वेक्टर इज दिस इज वेक्टर ए वेक्टर बी एंड वेक्टर सी. सो बी एंड सी आर कोलिनियर वेक्टर्स इफ दे आर पैरेलल टू द सेम लाइन. सो सपोज दिस इज लाइन एल बी एंड सी आर पैरेलल टू लाइन एल सो दे आर कोलिनियर वेक्टर्स. वेक्टर्स मीन वी हैव टू हैव द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस ऑल्सो ए बी पी क्यू. वेक्टर बी एंड वेक्टर सी आर कोलिनियर वेक्टर्स इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ देयर मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन. ओके, मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन डज नॉट मैटर बट दीज टू वेक्टर्स आर पैरेलल टू ए गिवन लाइन सो दे आर. नाउ वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट इक्वल वेक्टर्स. सपोज आई हैव वन वेक्टर इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इनिशियल पॉइंट इज ए एंड इनिशियल टर्मिनल पॉइंट इज बी एंड नेम ऑफ दिस वेक्टर इज ए वेक्टर. सपोज नाउ इनिशियल पॉइंट इज हेयर दिस इज सी एंड आई स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट. नाउ समवेयर दिस इज सी पॉइंट. सो फ्रॉम दिस अगेन द सेम लेंथ इक्वल टू द लेंथ ऑफ द स्केल दिस इज पॉइंट टर्मिनल पॉइंट डी. नाउ दिस सी डी वेक्टर सपोज दिस इज वेक्टर बी एंड ए बी वेक्टर इज वेक्टर ए. सो नाउ व्हाट वी से मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए बी इज इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर सी डी. That is, magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B. Likewise, the direction of vector A is same as that of direction of vector B. So, these two vectors are equal. So, we say vector A is equal to vector B. Next type is negative of a vector. Again, suppose I have one vector whose magnitude is AB, initial point is A, terminal point is B, this is the direction, so vector A is equal to AB. Again, suppose I have another vector equal to the length of the scale, the name of this vector is here B, this is BA, or we can say CD. Initial point is C, terminal point is D, but direction is this way. Okay, so B vector is equal to CD vector. Now, what we say? Vector A is equal to negative of vector B. Here magnitude is same, but direction is in inverse form. That is, direction is opposite. Magnitude is same, but direction is opposite. Then we say vector A is equal to minus vector B, or vector B is equal to minus of vector A. This is called negative of a vector. Now we shall discuss the questions of exercise 10.1. So the very first question is, the statement of question number 1 is, represent graphically a displacement of 40 km 30 degree east of north. So first of all, the direction diagram, this is the direction diagram. Upward we have north direction, downward we have south direction, rightward we have east direction, leftward we have west direction. So what is the statement? Represent graphically a displacement of 40 kilometer 30 degree east of north. Of north, where is north? This is north. And where is the east direction from north? This side, we see east direction. So we have to make 30 degree angle from north to west. So this way, this is the angle from north to east side. What is the angle? 30 degree angle, first thing. And displacement of 40 kilometer from O to this point P, the distance is 40 kilometer, right? So this way, represent graphically a displacement of 40 kilometer OP is equal to vector, we can say R, vector R, and magnitude of this R is equal to 40 kilometers. Now what is the question number 2? Statement is, classify the following measures as scalars and vectors. The very first part, 10 kg. What is this? Of course, this is scalar. Scalar quantity. Okay, because this is only magnitude which is mentioned in part number 1. And what is there in part number 2? 2 meters northwest. This is vector quantity. Why this is vector? Because 2 meter is the magnitude as well as direction is given, northwest direction. So second part comes under vector quantity. Third one is 40 degree. 40 degree, just this is the measurement of angle. So this is also scalar quantity. Fourth one is 40 watt. Now what is watt? Watt is a unit of power which is equal to 1 joule per second. That means this is also a scalar quantity. Next we have 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. What is this? This is also a scalar quantity. What is coulomb? This is a unit of electric charge equal to amount of charge transferred by a current of 1 ampere in 1 second. Okay, so this represents the as the scalar quantity. Again, 20 meter per second square. What we say about this? Direction is not mentioned. So direction is not mentioned, it means this is also a scalar quantity. Now we have question number 3. Classify the following as scalar and vector quantities. The very first is time period, distance, force. What is force? फोर्स इज इक्वल टू मास इनटू एक्सेलरेशन. सो एक्सेलरेशन इटसेल्फ इज ए वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. इट हैज मैग्नीट्यूड एज वेल एज डायरेक्शन. वेलोसिटी वी, दिस इज आल्सो ए वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. इट हैज मैग्नीट्यूड एज वेल एज डायरेक्शन. वर्क डन, दिस इज द स्केलर क्वांटिटी. सो स्केलर क्वांटिटी वी हैव टाइम पीरियड, डिस्टेंस एंड वर्क डन. एंड वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज दे आर फोर्स एंड वेलोसिटी. Now coming to question number 4, we have question number 4. In figure, a square is given. Identify the following vectors. Number 1, co-initial. Co-initial vectors mean two or more vectors having same initial point. So what we see here, vector A initial point is this point, and vector D initial point is same. So vector A and vector D are co-initial vectors. Okay, next is equal vectors. Equal vectors mean those vectors which are in same direction, vector D and vector B, they are in the same direction, as well as magnitude is also equal. Vector B and vector D, they are in the same direction, as well as their magnitude is also same, because this is the figure of a square. Collinear but not equal. Collinear here, vector A and vector C. Vector A and vector C, they are collinear but not equal. Why? Equal vectors mean they should have same magnitude and same direction. Here direction is not same. So these two vectors, A and C vector, they are not equal. Rather, they are collinear vectors. Next we have question number 5. Answer the following as true or false. The very first one is, a vector and its magnitude and negative of the vector are collinear. So this is true, because collinear factors mean two vectors are said to be collinear if they are parallel to each other, irrespective of the direction. Second part, two collinear vectors are always equal in magnitude. So this statement is false, because collinear vectors, they should be parallel to each other, irrespective of the direction and magnitude. Third one is, two vectors having same magnitude are collinear. So this is again false, because the definition of collinear vectors mean the vectors should be parallel to each other, irrespective of magnitude and direction. Next part is part number 4. Two collinear vectors having same magnitude are equal. So again this is false, because equal vectors mean they should be equal in magnitude and direction should be same. But two collinear vectors, if magnitude is equal and direction is opposite, even then they are collinear vectors. So this statement is false. So that